When you think WSU, it's Cougars which come to mind. But tucked away in one campus corner is one of the foremost grizzly research programs in the world. Using a combo of trained grizzlies raised from cubs and wild relocated problem bears from Montana, Wyoming, and elsewhere, the scientists study all aspects of bear biology and behavior.
This is about as close as you want to come to a grizzly, but I have to tell you, in watching them, it's fascinating to see these bears' behavior as they work with the researchers and each other in this learning environment.
Having the trained bears is kind of handy. We can do it on a moment's notice. We don't have to use drugs, and we can perform some procedure like a blood draw every 2 or 4 hours for a particular study if we need to.
Researchers are studying the grizzlies' diets and hibernation patterns, what causes stress, and what makes them happy. The trained bears will even give blood and hair samples on cue. It's work nearly impossible to do in the wild, although techniques learned here are helping backcountry research.
We can take those techniques now and apply them in the field and understand from just a hair sample or a blood sample what that animal's been eating, if it's pregnant or not, what the stress factors may be, and a lot about its metabolism and biology.
Discoveries include the bears' pregnancies, which are delayed by months, and their fall consumption of 25 to 30,000 calories a day, which may hold the secrets to understanding human obesity and diabetes.
I think some of the more surprising things are just how well these guys can solve a complex problem and how they can solve it by observation.
Beyond the hard science, what we're learning about the WSU bears will help us here in grizzly country, where human-bear encounters have been on the rise.
They're quite social, they're quite interactive, they can be quite playful like a dog, but their social cues are very different from a dog, and I think from that standpoint, people misinterpret bears. And so the saying, smarter than your average bear, is a really good one, because bears are smarter than your average dog, and they have similar problem-solving abilities to a person, in such that they can generalize, take a situation and generalize how to solve this particular problem for a goal. And really, bears are all about food. It's about solving the problems to get themselves fed.
There's hope of expanding the center so more bears, including the relatively unknown polar bears, can be studied. And there's always room for more students if you have what it takes.
Students have to love bears. They have to love bears, and they can't be afraid of getting dirty. That's a big one. And you have to have a little bit of nerve.
Nerve indeed, but also a sense of appreciation for these big critters and what they're teaching us. On special assignment, Dennis Bragg, MTN News.